Checking in with Rochelle. All morning long, you've been giving us some insight into the Hearing Loss Month awareness. What are you chatting about now?
Well, you know what? I had the mold done of my ear, and I'm back with Iris Spiegel, who is with Beltone
right now.
Okay.
So now, remember before it was all sticky and everything? Now it's perfectly hard. I just pull it right out of your ear, and voila, there's your ear mold.
Okay, so now...
Well, you got small canals.
Now that you have this, what do you do with it?
Well, if you needed an ear mold made, we would take this, and now they do it with 3D printing.
Okay.
So they would scan this and then print a 3D and make a custom mold for you.
That's cool.
And the mold would go into a hearing aid like this, or make a mold for behind-the-ear hearing aid.
Okay. So let's talk about some of the technology out there, because the hearing aids seem to be getting smaller and smaller, very discreet.
Right.
And this is what people want.
That's right. And the technology that goes with these hearing aids is absolutely fantastic. You've got lots of programs. You can have different programs for restaurants, for outdoors, for music, for normal situations. And you can control them by pushing a little button on the back of the hearing aid.
Wow.
But technology has gone one step further, and we now have a program where we can actually control the hearing aid on your iPhone or your iPad or your iWatch. So what you can do is you can make the hearing aid louder and softer, either together or individually. You can adjust the different settings. You can go from the all around to the restaurant.
So if you're in a restaurant, there's lots of background noise.
Right. You push the restaurant button.
Yeah.
And then you go into something called sound enhancer. And this is really neat because you can adjust the scope of the hearing aid. So if you're sitting with one person, you want to really narrow the range of the hearing aid so you're only picking up that person. You're with a group of people, you can widen it to pick up more.
That's really cool.
If you're outdoors, you can actually, through the sound enhancer, you can adjust the background noise and also the wind noise.
Wow.
Wind noise. Okay, there's another really great feature on the hearing aids. If you lose your hearing aid, the hearing aids are geotagged, and so if you lose it somewhere, the program will tell you exactly where your hearing aid is. If you've lost it somewhere in the house, you have a little hot and cold, and the closer you get to the hearing aid, the higher the bars go.
Okay.
So you can always find it that way.
We're almost out of time already. People should get tested when?
Everyone should have a hearing test before they're 50 to get a base test, whether there's a hearing problem or not. And then once you're over 65, you should get at least tested every couple of years.
Okay, and then your website?
Website is beltone.ca, and we've got a new hearing aid now that can be remotely programmed. You don't even have to go to the office to get your hearing aid adjusted. You can do it through your smartphone.
All right. Again, one in five Canadians have some kind of hearing problem and don't get tested, so go out there. If you're experiencing some problems, get a hearing test.
And thank you to you both for raising awareness this morning. It's definitely sparked a lot of conversations here, Terry. We're even talking about the earphones. A lot of people running outside with earbuds. You have to be careful.
Yeah,
absolutely. I've seen people driving their car with their earbuds in and whatnot. Yeah, absolutely. That's what the radio is for. It doesn't have to be driven right into the eardrum.